next year, you need to have testimony that I sat here and it's from this and that line that so and so spoke that I am who I am today. We sat on this same table with people like Emzia, and we still met those people this year and we still did work. But you see, it was just out of the conversation. If I didn't come, I wouldn't have met Emzia. Or Emzia wouldn't have known who I was. You see, so the people you meet, the words they speak, the lives they live, all these things matter. Now if we had said that KRS-One is done and is ready to rap and bless the microphone, maybe MCs would show up. But you see, MCs don't have time for this, which they call bullshit. Like, man, what are they gonna tell me? What's Silas gonna say? Like, oh, Black Lion isn't down now, who cares, man? Like, so at the end of the day, when you shine, these are the people that start hating. These are people that go out there and not celebrate who we are. They just claim who they are.
They'd
rather go to New York or go to DC and they say, are there a bunch of MCs in Africa? And say, come on.
That's
you know,
us.
You know, on the internet? Why do you think I'm here? I'm representing because I'm the only one in Africa. Like, I'm the only MC in Uganda. That's why I'm here. They wouldn't say that, look here, actually I'm here because a brother called Jimmy in Africa couldn't afford a visa. So I'm stepping in, I'm representing. The brother say, oh, I'm the best, you know, and I met so and so, you know, this is how we cover up everything. It doesn't require you to have a published TV station. You can develop a YouTube channel where people gonna celebrate truth. My dream for last year and this year has been to push my truth from Africa, and thankfully next year I really want to run interviews on people and, you know, put them out there for people to know that I am Spider MC and this is what I do and this is my video. You can find me on Facebook, you can find me on this, so that people can connect with you, so that people can get to know what Bantu Clan is, you know. If you're gonna sit down and say, oh, Silas is doing a great job and we see it on Facebook and he's pushing, we need all of you to begin pushing your brothers. Then the movement will grow, then everything is gonna be big. Not to wait for all man Silas when it comes in December, we're gonna have big global. We need to hear big global, in wherever you come from in Kabale. You know, let's see people sitting in a banana plantation talking about hip hop. Whether they are informed or whichever level, but they have something to share. You know, impact can never be too big or too small, it's impact. You know, so we sit here to celebrate, and the task that we hold right now is to show whoever didn't show up these 2 days that we are actually different from who they are. Whether we are making money as MCs or not, we live a different life from what they live. So I will sit on the same table with people like Bunny MC and tell him, like, look here, I'm not just an artist. I am a stakeholder, and I will tell you that what you're doing with end of the week, I am not happy. You're just trying to create an impression. But MCs are just there. The BBs are sleeping. You know, you still bring us the MCs that you brought to us 10 years back, and you're telling us that they're not kids in the ghetto rapping. They're not MCs that should be shining, taking your challenge or whatever. Now guess what? We have a festival, hip hop festival. And we're waiting to see the progress of that festival come next year, 2016. We're waiting to see.